Greetings, and the name of this video is Artists and Groups That Had Number One Hits and the Songs That Were Number One Hits, They Hated Them. And I'm going to explain to you why they hated them. And I'm going to give you a list of 10 songs. Number one on the list is Coolin' the Gang, Celebration. Most people don't realize that Coolin' the Gang is an accomplished jazz band. They're known for their jazz compositions like Hollywood Swingin', Summer Madness, just to name a few. And they took a chance and decided to record a pop song, and it was called Celebration, and it became number one. It got to the point that they hated to even play this song live because they said in a recent interview that it's a sad tragedy that in 50 years from now, when they're dead and gone, when people think of Coolin' the Gang, they're gonna think of that sappy song Celebration as opposed to Summer Madness. Number two on the list, Sammy Davis Jr. Sammy Davis Jr. agent said that it took him 2 years to convince him to record The Candyman. Sammy Davis Jr. absolutely hated that song. He felt that it was a children's song. And you know, he's known for doing, you know, ballads and standards. And he finally eventually gave in and recorded the song, and it became a number one hit in the 70s. And oddly enough, it was the only number one hit he's ever had. Number three, Neil Diamond, You Don't Bring Me Flowers. It was a duet with him and Barbara Streisand. And the reason why Neil Diamond really disliked this song, because being the diva that Barbara Streisand is, she didn't come to the studio to record it with him. She actually recorded her part 2 days later in a studio thousands of miles away. And Neil Diamond took offense to that because it's a ballad. And when you do ballads, you feed off of each other's energy. So as a result of that, he really didn't care for that song. Number four, The Beatles, Let It Be. This was during the time when The Beatles was on the edge of breaking up. And at that point, they just wasn't feeling it anymore. And it actually became a number one hit. Number five, Rupert Holmes and the Pina Colada song, Escape. Another novelty song and years of great writing. And unfortunately, Rupert Holmes is going to be known for that silly song as well, as opposed to these other great songs that he composed before the Pina Colada song. Number six, Prince, Controversy. The reason why Prince really despised this song, even though it took him to number one in the R&B charts, because Andre Simone actually wrote it. He did. Number seven, Chuck Berry, My Ding-a-Ling. Just the name, the title itself explains itself. Here's a man singing about his private parts at age 40, and in the chorus there's children singing. He despised this song, but it actually became a number one hit for him. Number eight, Carly Simon, You're So Vain. A lot of people thought that she was talking about Mick Jagger, but oddly enough, Mick Jagger was singing in the background of this song. The person that she was talking about was Warren Beatty, because he had recently bedded her and kind of kicked her to the side. So she despised the song. In spite of that, she recorded it and it became a number one hit. Number nine, Put the Police and Sting, Every Breath You Take. A lot of people think that this was a beautiful ballad and it's a love song, when actually it wasn't. It was a song about stalking. He was in the midst of divorcing his first wife and he was quite bitter, and he wrote a song that kind of summed up his feelings, and it became a number one hit. Number 10, Earth, Wind & Fire's Reasons. Another ballad or beautiful song that people thought was a beautiful ballad, when actually it was a song about cheating. If you listen to the beginning of the first phrase in the lyrics, it explains that to you, it gives you a hint. Love, craving your body, is a steal. Temperatures rising, I don't want to feel. I'm at the wrong place to be real. I repeat that, I'm at the wrong place to be real. A recent interview, Philip Beatty said it's amazing that people don't really pay attention to lyrics, because again, the song was about stalking. It had nothing to do with innocence or love and two people getting together and, you know, and enjoying a relationship. It was two people sneaking around, and at any point in time or any time that they were given opportunity to get together, they did. So there you have it, 10 songs that went to number one, and the artist that recorded them hated it, or hated the songs. And until next time, take care.